Hello guys. Mayroong nagano dito. Nag-replace sa aming kitchen sink faucet kasi nagli-leak siya. Bumili kami yesterday ng ng faucet. It's over $100. It's $119. And tumawag kami ng plumber para i-install siya today. I am so surprised talaga guys kung magkano ang mabayaran namin. Imagine pag-replace ng faucet dito sa Amerika, it will cost $400. Oh my goodness. Magtatanim ako ng aking flowers today. Ayan. At tingnan nyo, mayroon akong tinanim na sibuyas. At ano na siya, nabuhi na. Nabuhi na akong sibuyas. Yan guys. Para talagang mahal talawa akong porma o pa kunanod lang. I just woke up guys. Grabe mahal. Makalunghat o presyo. Nagsakit akong dughan. 20 mil. 20,000. Para mag-replace o faucet. Holy Christ, guys. Makasakit o dughan.
Later.
Hi guys! Katatapos lang natin mag-gym! It's Wednesday today. And it's, it's 6:30. 6:30 p.m. na guys. At we're heading home na. But before tayo mag-drive pa uwi, let's first. Okay, so before tayo mag-drive pa uwi, guys, ay mag-chikaan muna tayo, mag-chika update muna tayo. So, today is Wednesday, and I usually work out Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, guys. But, kung meron kaming mga ibang lalakarin, so I will just work out like 2 times a week. Yan, so I am so happy with the result, guys, kasi before I was I weigh 112 pounds, then down to 107 pounds, then now I am 103 pounds. Yay! Good job. So that's the secret, guys. So yung para sa mga mommy dyan na gustong mag lose weight, so you just need to keep going, mag-exercise, kasi we need to love ourselves, no? Kasi we need to take care of ourselves kasi nobody will do it for us. So we need to love ourselves then para hindi mawala yung confidence natin sa sarili kahit na may anak na tayo. Okay, so we need to exercise kahit nakakapagod minsan, but you gonna love the changes in your body when you can see the result. Hindi yan like instant. You need to work hard para mag-gain ang inaasahan mo na body, no? Body transformation. So anyway, ang update natin guys is sa bahay namin mag-gagawa ako ng video ng tour sa aming bahay. Yes, as a remembrance kasi mga hindi natin alam. Basta gusto ko lang magawa ng video na mag-tour sa bahay kasi we are planning na we're not planning to stay here in the US for good. We're gonna move to the Philippines, so at least I'm gonna have a remembrance sa aming bahay. So ayan, by the way, so sobrang na-shock talaga ako sa price ng pag-change sa faucet namin, kasi nag-leak yung kitchen faucet namin, tapos bumili kami ng bagong faucet, at ang presyo lang ng faucet, guys, is $99.99. But we were looking for a plumber to install the new faucet para mawala na yung leak. Can you imagine how much the cost to install it? It cost $400. Oh my goodness. Yeah, I was really shocked. $400 to just install, replace the faucet. And they gave us 10% discount. Kasi discount sa mga retired military. So, ayun, naka 10% discount kami, guys. But, napakalaki. Sobrang mahal. Hindi maiwasan na makumpare ko. Naku-culture shock ako, even if I'm already almost 3 years. Mag 3 years na ako dito sa US. I am still this experiencing culture price shock. Yes, $400, almost 20,000 pesos. Minus the discount, let's say 15,000 pesos for replacing a faucet. Yeah, replace, because we've been very busy. There's a lot of things going on in our life right now. There's a lot of things that minsan nakaka-stress, you know. There's a lot of things going on in our life. So, ayan, hindi ako nakapag-vlog ng 2 weeks. But anyway, that was the update, no, sa nangyari 3 days ago. So, ayun, $400. I mean, minus the discount. So, nasabi ko na, let's say, in pesos, 15,000. Sobrang laki. Kung nandun pa tayo sa Pilipinas, it will just cost us maybe 1,000 pesos ang pinaka-maximum na mababayaran natin sa mga, you know, like professional plumber. But here, OMG. I remember also last time na nag-replace kami ng toilet sa aming, sa bahay, na nung bagong bili pa namin yung bahay. $300 also to install. Mahal. Sobrang mahal dito in terms of mga ganyan na mga gawain. Mga plumbing work. So, it is expensive. And to replace a fence, $2,000 plus, $2,200 pag replace sa fence sa back namin. Sobrang mahal talaga dito, guys. Sobra talaga, oo. So, yan yung cost of living dito. At unti-unti na ding nag-increase ang presyo ng gasolina dito. You know, when Biden naging president, slowly nag-increase yung presyo ng gasolina. So, yan. And, yeah, we were not planning really to stay here in the US for good. We're gonna move back to the Philippines, hopefully. And the plan is, I'm gonna going back to the Philippines for vacation, guys. I am planning to go for a vacation this year, hopefully. Kalawian sa Ginoo, by October or November. Depende, but kami lang ni Hayden this time because I really have an important thing to do in the Philippines. Hopefully, everything will be back to, you know, like, not very complicated. Right now, nabalik na ang balikbayan na program. Kasi si Hayden, before, hinold nila sa immigration yung balikbayan program, na meaning yung mga US citizen ay hindi allowed. They need to have a visa to travel to the Philippines. But now, it was reinstated na last May 1. So, pwede na maka-travel without a visa. But they need to travel with the Filipino citizen. Like me, for example, si Hayden, he is a US citizen. Pag nag-travels siya together with me, maka-avail siya sa balikbayan na good for 1 year. So, with David. But before May 1, kailangan nila ng visa. They need to apply for a visa, yeah. But si Hayden, na-report ko na ang kanyang birth sa US Embassy sa Washington. So, na-register na siya. At pwede na akong kumuha ng birth certificate ni Hayden doon sa atin kasi na-register ko na. We really need to register ang birth nila sa embassy, US Embassy sa Pilipinas, para they will be recognized and they will become a dual citizen. So, kapag hindi mo na-register more than a year ang anak mo, you need to, when you register, when you report the birth of your daughter or your son, you gotta pay a penalty, and there's also an affidavit that comes na kailangan mong ipasa explaining why it was registered late. So, ayan, a little hassle. And now, guys, I'm still waiting for the update for my green card status because I am still under 2-year green card. I am CR1, conditional resident. So, last June, nag-submit na ako to remove the condition of my residency here. And hindi pa ako naka-receive ng any update. The status of my case is still the same, na na-receive pa nila yung aking petition, but wala pang update, guys. So, I'm still waiting for that para ma-receive ko yung 10 years green card ko. And after that, I am planning to apply for to become a citizen here in the US. So, I still need to submit paperwork and take the exam, so on and so forth. So, hopefully, maging smooth yung process, at yan yung plano namin, kasi we don't really wanna move to the Philippines and just left everything behind here, na hindi ko i-pursue yung aking citizenship, kasi when we move there and in case there is a need for us to come back here in the US, walang problema, no? Walang problema kapag mayroon akong US passport. You know, we don't know what will happen in the future. Maybe there's a need for us to come back here, especially for David, if like emergency, like hospitals problem or any something like surgery, ipalayo lang. David is free, everything is free for him here in the US sa kasi he is a veteran, so everything is covered here in the US. So we need to be prepared, and it's good also to be prepared and look, you know, kanang maging kwanta, think in advance, you know, para maging okay ang lahat. So yan yung update natin, guys. And in our next vlog, I am going to show to you I'm gonna do a house tour, tour sa aming bahay dito sa US, guys, para makita nyo naman yung aming bahay para remembrance na rin sa akin. Ayan, so without no kanang maura to so far atong update, guys, then I'm really happy sa result because I am losing weight and I am so happy for that. And that's it, guys. I'm gonna see you again later sa aking next videos. And if you like my videos, guys, if you have questions, just comment down below. And please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Bye-bye! Signing off, iVelicious. Bye-bye, guys.